Hi, hello dear students. I feel very honored bound to meet you all through this video session. I am your English teacher, Mr. Oscan from Bharathidasanar Matriculation Higher Secondary School of Arakkonam. Today, I feel much happy to deal with poem, which is prescribed in 10th standard Samachi textbook. The poem name title is Life. It is in English. So, in the first unit itself, you are going to experience a new thing, because the title itself invites all of you to think differently and to have right perspective towards life. Being a 10th standard student, now you have come to this level. Students, you may have a great scope about your future, and this is the first step you are going to take, and you must have right understanding over life. Okay, let's see. So this poem Life is beautifully written by the poet, namely Henry Van Dyke. I repeat, Henry Van Dyke. Students, you may commit a spelling mistake here, because Henry Van Dyke, the word H-E-N-R-Y, it is not D. H-E-N-R-Y, Henry Van Dyke. So all the first letter of the words are capitalized, Henry Van Dyke. So you can see this whole picture. So if you are asked the question, how will you define a life? You will be giving different types of answers. Someone will say life is so beautiful. Someone will say life is a race. Other person will say life is so wondrous. Other person will say life is always, it's like a flower with full of thorns. But you must know that life is not clearly a bed of roses. It may be sometimes filled with thorns. So keeping it in mind, let's know that the title of this poem is Life, and the author or the poet of this beautiful poem is Henry Van Dyke. And you must know that we have got different types of poems, among which today the genre is going to be on the poem division is sonnet. What do you mean by sonnet? Sonnet is a poem which consists of 14 lines. So that is what we say sonnet. And you must know that total number of lines comes here is 14. Dear students, let's know something about the author. So as I told you already, he is Henry Van Dyke, was born in the year 1852 and died in the year 1933. He was an American author, poet, educator and a clergyman. So he served as a professor of English literature at Princeton University between 1899 and 1923. So nearly for 24 years he served as a professor in Princeton College. And he was elected to the American Academy of Arts and Letters and received many other honors. Students, he is one of the very famous poets, and he has won so many readers for his poems. Now let's see. As I told you already, sonnet is, the word sonnet is derived from the Italian word sonato. I repeat, sonato, which means a little song or small lyric. In poetry, a sonnet consists of 14 lines and it is written in iambic pentameter. The word pentameter, penta refers to 5. So there will be 5 syllables, so there it consists of 10 syllables each. The first 8 lines of the poem is known as octave. The word oct refers to 8, and the last 6 lines is known as sestet. So it comes as 8 plus 6, 14 lines of this poem. So sonnet can be categorized on the basis of their rhyme scheme. So now let's know. So this poem, it consists of 14 lines. The first part of the stanza consists of 8 lines and the remaining part is 6 lines. Thus 40 lines come. The first part of this octave and the second one is sestet. Students, I have given here the full poem. Let's see the first stanza alone. I would like to read it for you. Please follow after me. Stanza number 1. Let me but live my life from year to year, with forward face and unreluctant soul, not hurrying to, not turning from the goal, not mourning for the things that disappear, in the dim past, not holding back in fear from what the future veils, but with a whole and happy heart that pays its toll, to youth and age, and travels on with cheer. Students, some of the words here I have put in blue color because these are the important words which are prescribed for us in glossary, and there will be a question for you from this in appreciation question. What do you mean by unreluctant? What do you mean by veil, stole, mourning? Sometimes you may be also asked in synonyms of our 10th standard. Students, I would like to read this in the form of another poem, so that there it has a different tune. So I would like to sing it for you. Please follow after me. Let me but live my life from year to year, with forward pace and unreluctant soul, not hurrying to, not turning from the goal, not mourning for the things that disappear, in the dim past, nor holding back in fear from what the future veils, but with the whole and happy heart that pays its toll, to youth and age, and travels on with cheer. So I hope you have formed this. So let me but live my life from year to year. So the poet says that here the word me refers to the poet himself. So he says that I would like to live my life completely, fully, wholly. So he wants to live his life thoroughly. So from year to year, from his childhood onwards, now he has attained the age of, as a professor, he is working, serving as a professor in the Princeton University, and he says that I would like to live my life from year to year, with forward face and unreluctant soul. With the forward face, what do you mean by forward face? So you must know that here the word face refers to our face, and you must also know that the face comes under verb, vinaichol endru solvanga. So verb, so it's a nice understanding that we must face everything face to face with smiling face. We must face everything face to face with smiling face. So that's what we see, that with the forward face and unreluctant soul. What do you mean by unreluctant? The word unreluctant refers to willing to do something. Reluctant learner. So they say that there are two types of learner. Hello Vijay, what do you mean by reluctant? Reluctant learner is a learner who doesn't have any willingness to learn something. So in the whole of the class we will have two types of students. They may be one student is a willing learner and a reluctant learner, unwilling learner. But here unreluctant soul. Soul is a beautiful word he uses. So soul is immortal, that you must know that with the forward face and unreluctant soul. About what? So we must have the courage to face the life with full guts, and not hurrying to, not turning from the goal, not hurrying to. Not simply hurrying or a rustle bustle or hustle for anything, or always they say that haste makes waste. Padariya karyam sidarum, padarada karyam sidarade. So in that way, not hurrying to, not turning from the goal. So we must have a fixed goal in our life, that we should not be sidelined, we should not get ourselves away from the goal. We must be always focused towards the goal so that we can attain our goal. And not mourning for the things that disappear, not mourning for the things, mourning for crying over the things which all have been lost. Most of the time, we always worry about our past. Instead of living in the present, we think about our past. Sometimes we are in an anxious mood to think of our future. So, must know that past is a history, Future is a mystery, present is a gift, so that it is called present. So we must know that we have to live in the present, that is what, not mourning for the things that disappear. Sometimes we might have lost so many things in our lives, that we must know that, okay, the only thing I enjoy here is the time I have in my hand. That's what he comes to say, dear students, in the dim past. What do you mean by dim? It's a dull past. So there will not be any. So it will be so gloomy. So it will not be very shining. So in the dim past, most of the time our past will not have it. So it will fade away. They say that in the dim past, nor holding back in fear. Don't restrict yourself. Don't be a prisoner of your past. Be an architect of your future. So be the best person in the present from what the future veils. Sometimes the whole future we may not know. So what will happen tomorrow? What will come the next second? Nobody knows, because life is filled with so many mysteries. So say a bit, but with a whole and happy heart that pays its toll. Sometime we need to do justice to our own life. Students, I repeat, with the happy, with the whole and happy God, our heart must be filled with joy, and we must always offer the best from ourselves to youth and age, and travels on with cheer to youth and age. So here the word youth and age, it refers to sometimes, you know, he from his child onwards, he is attaining different types of, there are, they say that Shakespeare refers to the 7 different stages of life. From childhood onwards, the second childhood comes. So we come across so many types of different parts of our life. There he says that from youth to age, travels on with cheer. Cheer means joyfulness, a happy mood. So he always says that let us make ourselves happy and we always feel comfortable about that. So I have given you some of the beautiful pictures here. As I told you, we must be very focused towards our goal. See, the arrow mark is exactly at the midpoint of this whole part. And we the future is in our hand. When we do our best in our present time, the future is always in our hands. You can also see that you should not mourn for the things that have disappeared in your life. So instead of worrying about the past, let's enjoy the present and always keep the smiling face, so that we will have a forward face and unreluctant soul, and we can always move with a whole and happy heart. Now we shall move to the second stanza. The second stanza is, so let the way up the hill, wind up the hill or down, or rough or smooth, the journey will be joy. Still seeking what I sought when but a boy, new friendship, high adventure, and a crown. My heart will keep the courage of the quest, and hope the road's lost turn will be the best. I would like to sing this for you. So let the way wind up the hill or down, over rough or smooth, the journey will be joy. Still seeking what I sought when but a boy, new friendship, high adventure, and a crown. My heart will keep the courage of the quest, and hope the road's lost turn will be the best. My heart will keep the courage of the quest, and hope the road's lost turn will be the best. So you can memorize this poem like this. So I would like to explain this for you. So let the way wind up the hill or down. Sometimes as we climb upon our life to one stage to another stage, we may be able to see sometimes the hill or down. So it may be up or down. The hill may be here, the hill refers to another stage of our life. That time it will be ups and downs. So life is filled with ups and downs. There will be fluctuations in our growth, or there will be also a decline. That time what should we do over, rough or smooth? Here the oxymoron is used in the figure of speech. Oxymoron is a figure of speech where you see the two contradicting elements. Oh, rough or smooth, the journey will be joy. Still seeking what I sought when but a boy. Here the word when but a boy refers to when he was a boy, he had some huge admiration over his friendship, adventures, and a crown. Crown refers to the prize, but he says that I would like to continue the same as a boy. My heart will keep the courage of the quest, and hope the road's lost turn will be the best. My heart will keep the courage of the ghost. So there is a word quest, quest called seeking something with so much of longing, desire. There you have the courage of the quest and you simply enjoy your life. And hope, we must always have hope for the best so that our last turn will be the best. The word last turn here, it refers to our death, the final destination. Students, you must know that life is a journey. And then it is not a destiny. You must understand the concept. Dear students, so far we have seen explanation for each and every line. So as I told you earlier, sonnet consists of 14 lines. So we have seen for the first octave and next sestet. Let's move on to the summary part. So the poem Life by Henry Van Dyke is full of positivism. And beautiful, it consists of beautiful inspirational lines. So thus this depicts the poet's determination to live a purposeful, a positive and a fruitful life. So the poet here, you can see that the future, the present and the past, and you can see that it is always looking at the past, it is always forwarding, advancing towards future, whereas the present is the only thing that they say that the power of now we have to enjoy. So he says that he just wants to live in the present without mourning for the past or for the bitter past or fear about the future uncertainties, because nobody knows what is going to happen in near future. So he wants to move forward in life with a happy heart, paying all the dues demanded by the age and the youth, and he wants to continue to travel forward. He says that with cheerfulness I would like to move on. So that is what we have seen in the first stanza. In the second stanza, the poet, he comes further and expresses his determination to live a great life. So thus he invites all the readers, especially you students, dear students, 10th standard students, that you need to live a life which is always putting a, setting a role model for others. He says that he won't be frightened by the difficult, maybe the uphill road of life, whether he gets a rough road or a smooth road, he will always travel on with cheer. He says that over rough or smooth, the journey will be joy. Because he wants all the readers saying that he will continue seeking new friendship, because it consists of thrilling adventures where you can enjoy the cherish of the essence of the true relationship with others, especially in your school days. You can enjoy the relationship of your friends, especially even the friends, the mother of your friends also become your mothers. So, and a crown in the same manner whether when he was just a boy. He says that I would like to lead a life where I was in as a boy. So but a boy. So he is not a boy at present, but he says that he wants to live a life just like a boy. He is enjoying his life. So you can see also in this picture, he says his quest will never stop and he always continues with the hope that the last turn will be the best. Thus the poem gets over. You can also enjoy reading this poem again and again. I have already given you in the previously. So kindly make sure that you know all these terms, especially the word glossary part. You must be very familiarized with the first letter, unreluctant. Students, you most of you might have been get confused that you forget that word un. Actually reluctant is a word. We can see that reluctant means unwilling. So unreluctant is equal to willing to do something. Unreluctant means willing to do something. So the next word, mourning. Mourning word for what? Feeling or expressing great sadness. See, you will have a sad face, in a melancholic strain you will be. And the third one is veils. Veils is something, the future veils. Actually it is nearly personified, because you cannot see a future because it is filled with uncertainty. It is an abstract quality to hide or cover something so that you cannot see it clearly or understand it. And the fourth one is crown. The word crown refers to the prize or the money, the position offered for being the best person. He says that we have to enjoy the New friendship, high adventure, and a crown. At last, we can see that the word quest, refers to, he says that I would like to lead my life. I always seek the quest. So he is seeking something, a long search for something which is very difficult to find. Students, I hope you have understood what I come to say this. Now let's move on to the next part. It consists of the poetic devices, because when a poem becomes famous, it must consist of all these poetic devices. If you see this part, you can see that the first part we see new friendship, high adventure, and a crown. If you get this line and you are asked to give the right poetic device to be used, the first thing you have to say is it is a metaphor. It is a metaphor. It is a metaphor. Metaphor is an implied simile, we have seen. And if you are asked this line, from what the future veils but with a happy or a whole heart, the word it becomes it personification. Because personification is something which is personifying the quality of the human person. Normally, the future does not do anything but it veils. And the third one, if you see that to youth and age and travels on with cheer. If you keenly notice those two words like youth and age, it brings about two contradicting quality, thus it becomes oxymoron. The fourth one is over rough or smooth, the journey will be joy. The words rough and smooth both are in contrasting elements. So thus it becomes again oxymoron. I spell the word oxymoron O-X-Y-M-O-R-O-N. Fifth one, if you see that the sentence goes like this, the lyric of the poem, not hurrying to, not turning from the goal, not mourning for the things that disappear. When you have the repetition of the same words in the sentence or in the sentence consequently, subsequently comes, we call it anaphora. So anaphora is nothing but repetition of same words in a sentence given in the stanza. And the sixth one, if you see that, still seeking what I sought when but a boy. Here the word but, normally we use simile for the words like, just as. Now you can also refer to this term, but a boy. So he wants to live like a boy, as a boy. Thus the poetic device here used is simile. Students, I repeat, metaphor, personification, oxymoron, anaphora, and simile. All these poetic devices are effectively used. Now let's see the other part, rhyme scheme of the whole poem. So if you keenly observe this, I have given you two stanzas where you can see that, see how to find out the rhyme scheme. Rhyme scheme is something which you can find when you observe the last words of the given sentence. If you keenly observe the word ear, disappear. In the second and third line also you can see that the word soul, goal. So it has rhyme, similar rhyming sense. So thus eared, souls, goal appear. So the stanza here, the rhyme scheme will be A-B-B-A is the rhyme scheme for the given stanza. This is how you can find out the rhyme scheme. In the second stanza, in the dim past, not holding back in fear for what the future veils, but with a whole and happy heart that pays its toll to youth and age and travels on with cheer. Here also you can see, look into the last part of the word there, fear, whole, toll, cheer. So you can also have A, B, B, A. Students, I hope you have understood this rhyme scheme. There will be a question for you in the public pattern there. There will be a stanza given and you have to rightly find out and rightly say the what rhyme scheme of that particular stanza. Next to that, we have got the word called alliteration. In Tamil also we say that mudal eluthukal ondru pol vandal mona ilakkinaya paratil naam padikkirom allava adhe pagudhi dhaan ingeyum varugirathu. So alliteration enbadu, so it means, really means, when all the first letter of the given words in the lyric of the sentence, so it says alliteration. For example, in the first line, so let the way wind up the hill or down. Or rougher, smooth, the journey will be joy. If you keenly observe, the words way, W comes, wind, W comes. In the second line, if you see, the journey will be joy. The letter J and J, it comes. So, it has alliteration. Still seeking what I sought when but a boy. Here you can see, there are two different letters, S and B comes here. So, you can point out these and you have to write the answer. So, you are given a 1 mark. New friendship, high adventure and a crown. My heart will keep the courage of the quest and hope the roads lost and will be the best. The word B, the letter B here comes in these words, B and B. So, these are all alliteration in the given part. Students, I hope you enjoyed this whole session. So, at the end, I would like to give you the special thing for the study material and question bank along with this video. You can find in the below link where you can find, you can have your own practice. Students, I would like to end this video session with this beautiful quote. It's a picture of Buddha. He says that the secret of health for both mind and body is not to mourn for the past, not to worry about the future, but to live in the present moment wisely and earnestly. The word earnestly refers to seriously. I'm very happy that you have got my point, and you can also go on watching the videos sent to you from our school. Students, make sure you get into this subject, not only simply for scoring marks we are studying, because it is something, it is related to our life, because the whole poem has been philosophized by the poet, namely Henry Van Dyke. With so much of enthusiasm, I am leaving you now. We will meet in the next session. Thank you so much. Thank you for your patient listening. Thank you one and all.
கடைபிடித்து உடல் மண்டலம் தேடி அன்றாட வேலை